start with you.
Okay, one sentence, the difference. I think work ethic, like people tend to not work very hard. They make a lot of excuses. I didn't have any problem believing in myself, and I've always been a hard worker, so I just had to overcome a lot of mindset stuff. I really think that everybody's journey is different. Some people are great with people at first. Some people understand leadership at first. I understood a lot of things, but I had to work on people skills and mindset and negativity, and I think all of these people became a jewel before me. I was there at gold for a long time, over 2 years. Actually, I wasn't even gold. I went back to silver. I believed that I could do this, and so I wasn't going to quit, but I still worked at least 4 to 6 hours a day for 2 years when nothing happened. But I believed and I knew that if Kristen could do this and she had 4 kids, I could do it and I had 5 kids. Like, there was no excuses, and I really think that is a big difference. Like, anybody can do this, but they're just stuck in their excuses, and maybe it's because they don't believe in themselves or they're just not willing to invest that in themselves or their business.
Well, in mine, I had issues with believing in myself, but I did believe in the company and the products and the opportunity, so I still had that vision out there, and I had to overcome my own mindset issues and believe I was worthy of it. And also, I had to come to the realization that saying, well, I don't believe in myself, was an excuse that kept me stuck in not believing in myself. And what people feel sorry for us if we don't believe in ourselves, or think, oh, that's okay, you don't believe in yourself. All you're doing is lengthening the time. So get over it and quit saying it. Quit creating it with your words.
Yourself and your
your dream and your goal, and you forget about those connections with your team and showing up for them and caring about them and knowing what their goals are and helping them achieve them, you can't go anywhere forward without an army behind you. So don't forget about your army and make sure they see you, they know you, they love you, you love them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I always feel like there's like a little stepping stones, like take you to Ruby, and then that Ruby is kind of a place where people decide, I'm going to the top, or I'm just going to be comfy right here. In fact, that's something that we were talking about yesterday. So it's like either the vision for themselves is big enough, or like any of the things that these ladies mentioned. But I always, it's Andrew that always says, if their vision isn't big enough, they can't see it for themselves, they can't visualize it, they're not going to do it. So if they're applying all these things plus that vision, they're going to get there.
Yeah, so early on when I was young, I grew up thinking that if anything I wanted to do, a human did it. And I'm a human, I could figure it out. So, with I heard like Sonia and Helen said the other day, they said yesterday, who the five people you surround yourself with. And I went to see Brooke Hemingway speak one time, and she said that when she first started, she didn't surround herself with sidelines. She surrounded herself with people that she wanted to be. So she watched every YouTube that Sonia Dudley had out there. She watched every YouTube that Celeste had out there. And so, if you want to get to that next level and you're stuck, who are you? Who are your five friends you're surrounding yourself with?
Mm-hmm. Great, James.
That's so good. Jerry.